Anything you want to say about Lebanon, which is where you are right now?
Well, Lebanon's falling apart. It's really sad. The economy's collapsing. Coronavirus and lockdowns are making it a lot worse. But also the country has really bad health infrastructure, so it has to lock down so it can't, because it can't handle a virus surge. I am currently shocked. I've had electricity the entire time we've done this interview, because since I've gotten back here, I've been here almost 3 weeks. The electricity has been like horrible, like in a way I've never experienced in my life in any place ever, to a shocking degree. So I'm just happy the lights didn't go out while we were talking. And I don't know, you know, the country's only going to get worse. There's like hyperinflation here, extreme devaluation of the currency. People's like life savings are basically worthless now, and so are their salaries. It's awful. It's a pretty miserable situation. So, as bad as the U.S. might seem, it does have a functioning state and electricity. Yeah. That's the nicest thing I can say about America from here. Because America kind of sucks right now, too. I mean, there's like a huge unemployment crisis. But basically all the things that are happening in the U.S. Are terrible. But in actual developing countries and third world countries, it's like that multiplied by a million. Because of like the situation with the virus and people's like the precariousness of people's like economic livelihoods, and everything just sucks right now.
Right.
And as an American, it's funny. Lebanon's one of the only places I can actually travel.
Oh yeah. Is it not? I mean, if you walk around, it
depends where
look...
you, it depends where you walk. But right now it's like a million degrees and really humid, and the electricity keeps going out, so you've got no AC. So that part feels pretty awful. But there's, I mean, Lebanon's also a beautiful country. It has like a very diverse landscape. It's got like beach, you know, it's got the sea, the Mediterranean Sea. It's like a huge coast with like beaches. And then it's got beautiful mountains. And so there's a lot of nice things about it. It's just going through a really, really rough time right now. And American sanctions on Syria and sanctions on Iran are actually making the situation in Lebanon worse. So it's like, you know, the U.S. sucks for that. Right. I mean, Syria is going through a really rough time right now. The U.S. just enacted the most draconian sanctions, I think, in history, where like you can't do business with any Syrian entity, government or private, or you will be sanctioned. It's like if America, if another country came to North America and told Canada and Mexico that they would suffer, like any business person in Canada and Mexico will suffer from sanctions if they do business with anyone in America. That's what America is doing to Syria and the region right now. And for countries like Lebanon that are going through an economic collapse and need trading partners and need places that they can buy goods from, like it's even more devastating.
It's like cancel culture, but lethal.
It's like canceling entire countries. Right? Yeah.
And by association and making them toxic so that other countries can't do business with them.
Oh my God. I think that like cancel culture actually might be an extension of U.S. empire.
Well, maybe we could get Barry Weiss et al. To care about imperialism and destruction and sanctions and literally deadly Barry sanctions Weiss, if Barry we make Weiss. It part of cancel culture.
Well, Barry Weiss supports cancel culture when it comes to canceling entire countries. If I'm not mistaken, right? Like she's pretty support. I mean, she called Tulsi Gabbard an Assad toady
and didn't know what that meant.
Didn't know what it meant, but she tried to cancel Tulsi Gabbard for opposing war on Syria.
Yeah.
Because war, if you're, you know, it's funny, these cancel culture warriors, like I wonder what Barry Weiss has to say about Venezuela. How does she feel about the U.S. canceling Venezuela?
I'm sure. I mean, he's a brutal dictator who's killing his people. I'm sure she would say that or something.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
So I'm like,
as opposed to Donald Trump, who's like not a brutal dictator gassing his people. I wouldn't call him a brutal dictator, but he has.
He's authoritarian. I mean, he has way less blood on, way more blood on his hands than Maduro.
Oh my God, yeah.